Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Gareth here from tastedshoots.com. So in the previous two episodes, we learned how to create various design elements for our book cover design. We learned how to create this 3D paper type composition, and we learned how to create the rainbow composition with the clouds. Now currently, they exist separately in their own documents. Now we did this for a good reason. Due to the fact these are rather complicated compositions containing multiple layers, we created these independently so we could focus on the specific job. Now, if we take a look at the final design, we can see that the 3D paper type has the clouds and rainbow around it. So in this tutorial, we are going to bring together all the creative elements we created over the past two videos and place them into the book cover document. In this tutorial, I will be demonstrating a smart way to manage complexity in Photoshop. So first, I'm going to begin by opening up the documents I have created over the previous three episodes. So I'll come into the project folder, I'll come into my project folder. Now, if you have been following along this far, you should have your documents saved in here. Though if you're new to this course and would like to follow along, simply navigate to the finished artwork folder and you can open the documents from there. So I'll select all the documents and open them in Photoshop. So here we have the book cover print document, which is currently empty. We have the paper type and the rainbow and clouds document open. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is focus on the paper type document. What we are going to do here is bring in the illustrative elements from the rainbow and clouds document to create the complete header design for the book cover. Once we are happy with that, we will then bring the main header composition into the book cover design. So, nice and simple, one step at a time. So with the rainbow and clouds document open, in the layers panel, we should have some nice, neat folders we created in the previous video. We have the balloons layer folder, the clouds folder, and the rainbow. So what we are going to do now is get the creative elements from this document into the header document. So I'm going to begin with the clouds. So the first thing I'm going to do is press V to activate the Move tool. I'll carefully select the Clouds layer folder in the Layers panel. Then I'll click into the Canvas area, then click and drag up into the tab of the 3D paper type document. When it appears, I'll place my mouse cursor into the document and release. Upon release, the clouds will now appear in my type document. Excellent. So upon dropping the clouds in, they now appear to be on top of the type. If we look in the Layers panel, we can see that the Clouds layer folder is at the top of the layer structure. So in the Layers panel, I'll drag the layer folder below the paper folder and place the clouds behind the type like so. Now inside the Clouds folder are all the Cloud Smart objects we duplicated in the previous episode. Also, we can see all the adjustment layers we apply to each cloud to adjust the brightness. So at this stage, these cloud elements are just fine. Now on this occasion, I may not be entirely happy with the position of the clouds around my type. Also, I have some clouds directly below the type. So next, I'm going to do a little editing of the clouds to get an arrangement I am more happy with. First, I'm going to get rid of the two clouds behind the type here. So with the Move tool active, I'll right click on the left cloud. I'll select the right layer from the pop-up menu. In the Layers panel, the layer will be selected. Now notice this layer also has an adjustment layer applied above it. So I'll press Shift and select the adjustment layer above. With them both selected, I'll press Backspace to remove them completely. Next, I'll right click and select the next cloud. I'll also select the adjustment layer above and press Backspace to delete. Next, I'll continue to right click on various clouds and select them from the menu that appears and move them around my type to get a better arrangement. If I wish, I may even use the free transform tool to resize the clouds. So once I have finished positioning the clouds around my type, I'll come back into the Layers panel and toggle up my folders so everything is neat in my Layers panel. So next, I'm going to bring in the rainbow element. So I'll first select the Friends folder in the Layers panel. Then I'll come back into the rainbow and clouds document. So this time, I'll click on the rainbow folder. With the Move tool active, I'll click into the canvas area and click and drag up into the Paper Type tab. Just like earlier, I'll drag the mouse cursor into the canvas area and release click to reveal the new element in my document. So I'll come into the Layers panel, right click on the Rainbow folder and select Convert to Smart Object. Next, I'll drag the Smart Object layer down beneath the Clouds folder, like so. Then I'll reposition up in the top right. I'll press Command T to activate Free Transform, press and hold Alt and Shift on the keyboard and scale down like so. Then position neatly behind the letter R of the paper and the cloud just to the right. Once happy, I'll press Enter to commit, and I might just need to right click on the cloud to select it and reposition like so. Perfect. So I'll come back into the Rainbow and Clouds document. I'll right click on a balloon and make sure to select the layer. In the Layers panel, we can see that this is currently a smart object that we created in the previous episode. So with the layer selected in the Layers panel, using the same technique, with the Move tool, I'll click and drag this up into the tab of the 3D paper type document and drop it in. In the Layers panel, I'll click the layer and drag it on top of the Clouds folder, making sure not to drop the layer into the Clouds layer group. I'll position the balloon up in the top left and scale appropriately using the Free Transform tools. So that completes the header composition. Now we have the clouds, the rainbow, and the balloon all positioned nicely around the main header type. Once I'm happy, I'll press Command S to save. So now we are ready to bring this header design into the empty book cover document. At this point, I'll click back into the Rainbow and Clouds document and close the document as we no longer need this open. On this occasion, I will not save. So after dragging in all the elements from the previous document into this paper type document, we now have quite a large layer structure containing lots of individual layers. We just used a drag and drop technique to take creative elements from one document and place them into another. Now for the next task, I'm going to use a different technique. So now I'm just going to come to File and Close and come back to the empty document. This time I'm going to come up to File, scroll down and select Place Embedded. Now if you're using an earlier version of Photoshop, this will only appear as Place instead of Place Embedded. So upon click, I will navigate to the project folder. Now, if you have been following along with this course from the start, you should have your document in your My Project folder. Though if you have only just joined this video, you will need to navigate to the Finished Artwork folder to the file you just saved. So I will come into My Project folder, I'll select the 3D paper type document I just made and click Place. Upon click, I will now see the composition inside my new document, with a bounding box around it. This will give me the flexibility to move it around and scale the composition to the size I wish. So I'll move the composition up to the top of the canvas area. I'll press Command Colon to activate the guides. I'll press and hold Alt and Shift on the keyboard and click and drag a corner point like so to scale the composition slightly. I'll make sure not to go outside my inner margins. Once satisfied, I'll press Enter to commit. And then I'll press Command Colon to toggle away the guides. So now we have a new smart object layer in the Layers panel. What I just did there was import the entire composition we made previously into this document as a smart object. So now that very busy layer structure in the previous document is only represented in this document by one layer. This will now make it very easy for me to manage this composition as one element in my main document. Simple. Though now we have a small problem here. Currently, we can see that the sky in the composition we just placed in is interfering with the sky in the main document. So now I'll come into the Layers panel and double click on the Smart Object thumbnail. Upon click, we will now jump into the Smart Object. And here we can see all the layers here in the Layers panel. So I'll come into the Layers panel and toggle the visibility of the background layer folder. And I'll toggle it to off and the white base layer. So now we can see the transparency in the background. I'll press Command W to close the document. When asked, I'll click Save. And now we are back in the main book cover document, and the header is now placed nicely on top of the main document background. Excellent. So to finish off, I'll come into the Layers panel. I'll select the new Smart Object layer. I'll press Command G to group this into its own layer folder and name this Header. I'll right click and assign a yellow color to the folder. And once I'm happy, I'll press Command S to save. So those are some of the methods you can use to manage your creative elements in a smart way. It really helps to keep in mind the nature of your creative elements and break them down so they become easy to manage, especially if you're beginning to create really complex design. When creating a complex design in Photoshop, it can quickly get out of hand and suddenly you will find yourself overwhelmed by lots of layers. This can get confusing for you or anyone who needs to work with your document, so it really helps in the long run and for a swift workflow to pay close attention to your housekeeping and stay on top of your layer structure. In this video, I demonstrated two scenarios. The first scenario, I was building up a particular composition, the header artwork. In that instance, it was appropriate to use the drag and drop technique from one document to another to build up the composition. In the second scenario, I used the place method to import a complete design composition into a document as a single smart object. This was done to break the main composition down into simple sections to manage complexity. So now we have the header section in the document, it's now time to move on. If we take a look at the finished design, under the header we have these paper bird characters. In the next video, we are going to create these characters and then bring them into our main cover document. See you in the next video.